About 2 million people in the United States are amputees. By 2050, that number is expected to reach 3.6 million. At the University of Pittsburgh School of Health and Rehabilitation Sciences, we're not only teaching students how to build prosthetics, we're teaching them how to interact with people who lost a limb.
Every time I meet a patient, I mean a new person, I have to introduce myself, I have to build that rapport, I have to build that confidence in that patient that, hey, I can do what I say I can do.
Students in the prosthetics and orthotics program do everything from getting to know the patient's needs to building and fitting them with new prosthetics.
Without us, a lot of these people would be wheelchair bound or like crutches. So like they come into, especially like people who get fitted for the first time after they lose it. Like it gives them that spark of hope.
One of those people is LaVon Richard.
I was mowing where the hillside, and I went under a tree, and the branch of the tree caught on the roll bar, and it was like a boomerang, because once it let go, it threw me off the tractor in front of it, and the tractor then ran over my leg, my foot, and then the tractor crashed into a tree.
Not long after that, her doctor had to make a tough decision.
I was laying there, and he says, listen, the only thing I can tell you is you might as well just get it cut off, because you'll be in nothing but pain. And that was like, that realization, I didn't understand. I mean, it sounds silly, cut it off, yes, you get it, but when that's a part of your person and cutting it off, it was, I'm like, what?
But being without a leg didn't damage her spirit.
She's an amazing woman. She's funny. She's the grandma that, she's like the grandma that you see on TV. She's the cool, crazy grandmother one. And she's a really good patient model.
Jessica Thomas built prosthetics for LaVon as part of her training.
I got to build two things for her, a check socket and a laminated socket. And in the real world, you do a check socket just to make sure, that's your check. We call it check to make sure everything is right. My check socket was awful. It was too tight for her.
And some legs feel really good and some legs are not good.
I know in her head she's like, oh my gosh, this is awful, but she's really nice.
I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings or ruin their day, but they have to know that something isn't right. So I just try to be diplomatic, but it is kind of hard, but I'm getting better at it. I'm getting way better at being able to say, this doesn't feel right.
Even when you have a terrible fit, you just learn so much more about what you should have done, what you can do, what you cannot do, how can you fix it.
That's what's important. You have to crawl before you can walk.
Program Director Sarah Peterson thinks this is one of the most important lessons for the students.
We encourage the students to make the mistakes here, so when they go out in the field, they're not making the mistakes at the facility that they're working at.
But how does it feel when a build fits perfectly?
That hard work paid off. It just feels so good, because like it's one thing to build it and have it look good, but it is also another thing to build it, have it look good, and actually do what it's supposed to do. So the fact that when it slides on nicely and it fits right, you don't need any suspension sleeves, 3-ply sock, that's all you need. You're just like, oh, that's what it feels like, okay.
And that makes me feel good, because they are happy that it worked that well. I would trust anybody that would come out of this program to build me a leg and take care of me.